Hello friends, today I welcome all of you on PVM Online. In English, today we are going to learn standard tense in which unit 1, 1.2 an encounter of a special kind, written by Tapan Mukherjee. Friends, this story has an unique message for all of us. In this story, there is a boy who saved, who cared, who nurtured, who nursed a baby male langur from a big dominant male langur who was willing to kill that baby langur. Friends, this story is nothing but an example of a bond of trust, compassion, love, and of course mutual understanding between man and animal. So the story is very beautiful. Let us enjoy the story. In this story, here we have the first passage. See now, my father was a medical professional working for a private company in Raniganj in West Bengal. The officers of the company were housed in individual bungalows inside a large campus. Our house was in corner of the campus. The officers' club was adjacent to the boundary wall of our garden. The compound was luxurious with green grass, colorful flowers, and a host of tall majestic trees. The seasonal vegetables in the kitchen garden of the household and the magnificent trees constantly attracted squirrels and many species of bird. A group of langurs had been even made their den in an ashwatha tree nearby. They had all become a part and parcel of our existence and daily life. See what is given in the first passage. Here, the boy whose father was a medical professional who works in medical profession in private company. Actually, they live in Raniganj in West Bengal. The officers of the company were housed in individual bungalows inside a large campus. Means there was a large campus. And in that large campus, the officers who were doing the job in that company, they were given maybe bungalows in that compound, in that large campus. Now, their house was at the corner of the campus. And by their house, beside their house, there was a officers club. There was a officers club. And in front of their house, there was a luxurious garden. There was a big garden in which you can find green grass, colorful flowers, and of course tall and majestic trees, tall and beautiful trees. You can find also that in that garden, seasonal vegetables were taken. Along with that, magnificent trees constantly attracted squirrels and many species of birds. See, in that garden, there were magnificent trees. There were magnificent trees, majestic trees, big trees, which generally attract to squirrels. Again, many species of birds. Again, important thing is that there was a group of langurs who accommodated on those trees, who used to stay on those trees. Specifically, the tree was there, Ashwatha tree, in which we call peepal tree, in Marathi, peepal tree. And here we can find that the writer, where his father, his father, mother, sister, they were living, it was nothing but a bungalow surrounded by a big garden, surrounded by trees, surrounded by beautiful, I must say that specifically there was vegetables in front of their house. And in this way, you can find all this was nothing but part and parcel of their life. Part and parcel means inevitable part, inseparable part. So all these become inseparable part of their life. Now story proceeds here. See, a small incident on a Saturday afternoon left a profound effect on me and unfolded before my eyes a whole new dimension to the wonders of God's creation. See, the story was taken, or it happened, the episode happened on Saturday afternoon. Here writer is saying that episode had left a profound effect, deep effect on his mind. It created God's majestic effect on his mind. So it was a beautiful effect which he could have at that time. See now what happened. It was a few days into the puja vacation. Just like for any other child, the holidays provided an opportunity for me to become engrossed in various magazines and storybooks published specially for children in the festive season. See, already puja vacation had started there. Puja vacation had already started there, but some days were left for specific puja worshipping. Now you can find that it was holiday. Therefore, writer thought that he should read as much as possible, as other children read the same way he wanted to read as much as possible. So he thought that it was great opportunity for him to engage himself. To engage himself in story reading, in magazine reading. So it was good opportunity for him. So therefore he thought to read much and more. So it was Saturday afternoon, and you can find that almost he liked to read the story. Therefore he's telling us specifically what happened with him on that Saturday, or with them on that Saturday. After a hearty lunch, my parents and younger sisters lay down for an afternoon nap, and I settled down with a storybook. The quiet afternoon presented the perfect backdrop for reading an adventure story. So, you know, after a hearty lunch, you can find that a whole sufficient wholesome food. So it was afternoon time, so he took wholesome food, he ate wholesome food, and his parents and younger sister, they were taking siesta. All you do, you know the meaning of siesta? Afternoon nap, that is called afternoon nap. So generally they were lying down for an afternoon nap. At the same time, he decided to read maybe magazine book, maybe story book. Specifically, he decided to read, that is given there, adventure story book. The quiet afternoon presented the perfect backdrop for reading an adventure story. The atmosphere was totally quiet. Pin drop atmosphere was there. So, as being silent everywhere, he thought it was a really good time to read adventure story. And therefore, he was busy in reading the adventure story. What happened with him? See there. The silence was occasionally broken by the sound of my family snoring and intermittent chirping of house sparrows, the harsh cawing of a crow, the shrill call of a kite flying high above the ground. He was busy in reading adventure story. He engrossed himself in reading adventure story, but it was intermittently, time to time, in middle time, it was broken by the snoring of his family. Specifically, maybe you know that's snoring is what? Can you remember the meaning of snoring? Snoring is a kind of sound created by somebody else who sleeps. At that time, whenever he breathes in, at that time he creates a sound that is that process is, or that sound is called snoring. So here you can find that he was in middle time, he was disturbed by snoring. Again, there were more sounds. See, the sounds of chirping of house sparrows. We have seen the house sparrows, chirping house sparrows. So here you can find that chirping of house sparrows, also their sound was also there. And again, harsh cawing of crow. Yes, cawing of crow. Crows which create sound at that time. So there was harsh sound of the crows also. And shrill call of a kite. Some boys were flying a kite. They were flying a kite outside. And due to that, we can find that the sound was created at that time of a flying kite. It also disturbed him. So every minute tick by means every minute was ticked by. He was reading a story the same way he was listening the sounds, disturbing sound. Still, we can find that he says, I became deeply absorbed in the book. See, though there was disturbance, still he became deeply absorbed, deeply engrossed in reading a book. See what happens next. Suddenly, I heard a group of street dogs barking furiously in the distance. I chose to ignore the commotion, thinking that the pack of dogs might have cornered a hapless pig. So he was reading a book, right? At that time, he heard the street dogs barking very furiously there. At first, he decided to ignore it. Thinking that some dogs might have cornered, they have encircled a pig. To attack. So he thought like this. Therefore, he decided to avoid it. But soon the barking became louder and more aggressive, and the alarm cawing of a flock of crows added to the cacophony. See now. Though at first he listened the sound of barking of furious dogs, later he was able to listen the sound of crows, specifically larger sound of crows. The word cacophony is used here. Cacophony means loud sound. Cacophony means harsh sound. You can find that he heard the barking of dogs the same way he heard the cawing of crows. All this disturbed him. All these may be responsible for him. All this responsible to distract him from his reading. So he says, I also heard the disturbance approaching closer. Curiosity got the better of me. Leaving the book aside, I rushed to the veranda to see what was going on. See now, what is did here? You can find that when he heard dogs barking, at first he decided to ignore. But the same way, after some time, he heard the sound of cawings of crow. So he thought something might have or might has happened there, and therefore he could not keep himself away from this. His curiosity aroused there. Due to his curiosity, he left his book aside and he tried to see what happened there. So leaving his book aside he rushed to veranda. What was happened there, he wanted to know. See what he could see there. I glanced toward the roof of a club house and saw something terrible or horrible. A big male langur, apparently leader of its group, was holding a baby langur in his hands and mercilessly beating it all over with a definite intent to kill. See, when he glanced there, when he looked at it, he saw on the roof, of the clubhouse, which was by the side of their garden, right? He saw that there was something terrible. What he could see? He saw a big male langur, apparently leader of its group, a big male langur, stout langur, very, of a big size. There were other langurs also, but it was, it appeared specifically, it appeared very stout one. Therefore, it was just like, it seemed at just like a leader. So, that leader, that male langur, that big male langur, it held a baby langur in his hand. It held a baby langur in his hand and it was mercilessly biting it. Mercilessly, very cruelly. Very cruelly, it biting it. And you can find that it was biting that baby male langur. And all this he could see there. At the same time, he saw that the helpless mother of the baby and the other lesser members of the langur group were scattered on the roofs of the buildings nearby, watching the baby being killed. This dominant male langur, it was biting mercilessly. The mother, which was helpless, the mother along with other members of group were helpless there. They could see only this big male langur, dominant male langur, was biting that baby langur. They could not do anything else. And in this way, when that boy saw, specifically that boy saw this, he says here, I recall the terrible custom of in the animal clan, according to which a dominant male usually does not allow other male baby or adult to survive within its group. See, when he saw all this, when he saw specifically a big dominant male langur was biting a baby male langur, he remembered a custom, he remembered a tradition. It is a tradition in animal, specifically clan. You know that clan? Clan means a very large family. In that same animal family, a male langur does not like the presence of other male langur. A male langur does not like the presence of other male langur. Okay? And in this way, you can find that all this reminded by the boy, all this custom reminded, all this tradition reminded by the by this boy. And see there what happened next. Without losing any time, I gathered a stout heavy stick in one hand and hurled a piece of stone at the marauding langur. The langur was so infuriated that it hardly took any notice of my assault. But then I started throwing more stones. The dog on their part raised their pitch of cry. See, you can find, friends, this male langur was biting, this dominant male langur was biting that baby male langur. So, as the writer came out and he saw all this, without losing time, he held a strong stick in one hand. In another hand, he took a piece of stone and he hurled it to that dominant male langur. And you can find marauding means the langur which was searching for something to steal or attack. So it was the langur which was biting. So writer took a hard stick there in one hand, in another hand he took a stone and he tried to throw it towards that male langur. But see what happened there. The langur was so infuriated, means that male langur was so angry that it did not pay any attention, it did not pay any heed to the attack, to the assault done by the narrator or done by this boy. Now see, but then I started throwing more stone. the dog on their part raised their pitch of cry. You can find that narrator or this boy found only one stone could not change the situation. So he kept that activity again and ever. So he tried to throw more and more stone toward that baby long, toward that dominant male langur. At the same time, the dogs which were down there, they were barking at that male dominant langur. And in this way, you can find that it was the situation created there. It was a situation created there. Now, okay. Now, the second part of the story, we will continue later on in our next episode. Till then, goodbye. Don't forget to subscribe our school channel. Okay, thank you.